If we had realized that this was a war of shadows, an intelligence war, we would have a huge percentage of the Muslim world on our side. And I can tell you that because I was on the streets of Tunisia, Cairo, Beirut, I was there.
Right. Well, so let me
just finish.
I'll give you a chance.
Okay. You talk about, you know, you dismiss this notion that somehow despair is unimportant, that these people react like barbarians because of the Quran. You know, if you go back and read the great philosophers on totalitarianism, on Nazi Germany, Hannah Arendt, Karl Popper, Fritz Stern, The Politics of Cultural Despair, they all write that what propelled the fascists forward, that what propels all totalitarian movements, and I include fundamentalists, Jewish fundamentalists, Christian fundamentalists, Islamic fundamentalists, Hindu fundamentalists, Karen Armstrong has done great work on this, what propels them forward is despair, personal and economic despair. And you see it within the United States, with the Weimarization of the American working class, the rise of an American oligarchy, the huge disparities that are creating. You can't maintain a democracy in an oligarchic state. And what's at fault in the Arab world is not Islam, but scummy little dictatorships like the one run in Saudi Arabia or Hosni Mubarak's in Egypt. It's the political system that keeps most people crushed under their heel. Egypt is a deeply repressive state, which we give $3 billion a year to. And let's also finally not forget that every time Israel sends those F-16 jets and Apache helicopters to strike refugee camps in Gaza, the fragments of those bombs have Dayton, Ohio, and other cities on